going to close out our service with the best way possible with the baptism.
Amen, everyone. Can we bring greetings from the Chosen Squad Ministries? Amen, we're really excited here. I want to personally introduce you guys to Teo Dominic Jackson Carver. And I just want to share a little bit about him. There's a scripture in Galatians chapter 6. It reads in verse 9, "Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up." The scripture is true about, of course, Keontae and his tenacity and his perseverance in studying the Bible with Teo, but also Teo himself. I think it's been a privilege studying the Bible with you. It's been an honor. I really appreciate you just giving your heart, giving your life. I remember we studied the Bible with so many people. And yeah, I think you're a special one for sure. Yeah, sure. You really give your heart. You really want to be a disciple.
Amen.
You know, and this guy. He's taking every challenge.
Come on, bro.
We showed him the scriptures, and he's like, "I want to be that. I don't want to be just like that. I'm going to change for Christ."
Yeah.
So I'm really excited. I'm really happy. I'm so proud of you. I'm looking forward to all the fun memories we're going to make on campus, all the people we're going to study the Bible with and share our faith with. And so I'm really excited. I want to let my brother Keontae share even more about you.
Come on,
I know when Mason and Natalie first got here.
Oh,
how blind I was to the world, how blind I was to everything. I seek out my own personal goals to become a game designer, to become an English major too, Japanese major. I want to be like 20 different majors. I want to be everything. I want to be there for people to help people be an ambassador. And like as I seek those, I was like wondering, oh, this is so much information, but was it doing? But what am I getting out of this? Like, temporary satisfaction. Even though I said no to become a disciple, I still notice how much stress I've lost through reading the scriptures, through learning about the scriptures. I've seen how much I've changed through reading the scriptures. I still said no, but I wanted to say yes.
Come on.
And I don't know why I was waiting for the mask again.
Come on,
but I got so many chances throughout my whole journey to become a disciple. I'm so grateful for God for giving me chance after chance after chance. God did come last Sunday, and I rarely think about that because I don't really hang out with as many disciples that I should be. I just stick with my family, I stick with my friends, and I just like ignore the whole God situation. And like now, I'm just thinking God could come right now, and I'm like, I'm gonna be done like this. Because I waited too long. I waited my whole life. I wasted my whole life. Looking for a purpose that wasn't there, I found it here. I found it all over the world. Everybody has given me. I'm grateful for my friend of each, for my friend of the year.
Come on!
I'm grateful for my mom's company, even though the air conditioning still mess with her body. I'm out here right now, but I know she's gonna be here. Whether it's before or after, I'm still thankful for her mom giving birth to me, for making me into a perfect chef. So it says, do not worry. Matthew chapter 6, verse 25-34. Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about how your body, what you will wear, is not life more than the food, and the body more than the clothes. Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in the barns. And yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Can anyone of you be worrying by worrying at a single hour of your life? And why do you worry about clothes? See how the flowers of the field grow? They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you that that night you saw him in all his splendor was dressed like one of you. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow and thrown into the fire, he will not much more clothe you of little faith. So do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after these things, run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that. Seek first his kingdom. Seek first his kingdom. And try to think of all these things he will give to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own.
Yeah!
I feel very angry because I worry about so much. I worry about my clothes, how people wear, where all the people think about me. After high school, I stopped worrying. But I still worry a lot. I'm
Amen. Amen.
Reading these scriptures, I learned that the people who worry for themselves, all you have to worry about is my relationship with God.
left.